So let's talk about options delta. You see, option prices are influenced by what they call the Greeks. And the Greeks are delta, gamma, and theta. This is just three of the Greeks. There is more. And you see, when you're trading options, it is important that you know about the Greeks and what they do. And today, we want to focus on delta. I want to show you exactly what delta is, and then we'll go through a specific example, and I'll show you a few things that you need to know about delta. So let's get started. Okay, there are the option Greeks. So delta is actually measuring the sensitivity, and it's a mouthful. I'll show you exactly what it means, of options premium relatively to the underlying asset. And what the heck does all of this mean? You'll see in just a moment, don't worry about it. So in a nutshell, it basically says, how much does the option price change if the stock moves $1 to the upside or the downside? Now, gamma is the rate of change of the delta. And we don't want to worry about that today because we want to focus on delta. What is it? What does it do? Why do you need this? Why is it important to know about delta? And then we have theta, and theta basically measures the so-called time decay. Now, I already did a video on theta, so if you would like to know more about theta, I'll link to this video in the description, right? But let's focus on delta. So what is delta? So delta is a number between 0 and 1 that measures how much the price of an option changes if the stock moves by $1. And again, all of this sounds super, super theoretical. So let me actually show you a very, very specific example. Now, the example that I want to choose here is Microsoft. I mean, it doesn't really matter what we use, but I want to show you right now, Microsoft is trading at 211.20. And now I want to show you different strike prices of options, because again, options have strike prices and expirations. If you're brand new to options and don't know even about strike prices, I did a video series, a playlist on options 101. I'll link it in the playlist here. So we'll also look at a different delta. We are looking at the current price of that option, and we will look at the new price of this option if Microsoft moves by $1 from 211.20 to 212.20. Okay, so we're bringing up an option chain. I want to bring up an option chain of next week. And you see, this is where we're expiring November 27th. This is the trading platform that I use. It's called Tastyworks. If you would like to know more about Tastyworks, I'll link to it in the descriptions as well. So as you can see, there are different call options on this side with different strike prices. And you can see that they have all sorts of different deltas. I'm displaying the delta here. So let's get started with the 205 that is right now trading at $7.25. The delta is 0.8. So what does it mean? So we are looking at the 205 strike. The delta is 0.8 because again, the delta is between 0 and 1. I'll tell you about negative delta in just a moment. The current price of the option is what we are seeing right here. We look at the last traded price. The last traded price is $6.92. So $6.92. So what does it mean? It means if Microsoft goes up by $1 to $212.20, that the new price is $6.92 plus the delta. So you see, this is where it's really important that you understand delta. Some people think that options move even more than the stock. And oh boy, this is not true at all. So option prices always move less than the stock price. And this is what the delta tells you. So the new price here of the option would then be $7.72. Okay, so this for a strike price of 205. And this is a strike price that is so-called ITM, in the money, because its value, its strike, is less than the current price. Now let's take a look at a strike that is at the money. And you see right now it's a little bit tricky because Microsoft is trading at 211. So let's just use the 210 strike price here. As you can see, the 210 strike price has a delta of 57. So let's write this down, 210, and this would be a so-called at the money with a delta of 0.57. Again, it is between 0 and 1. The current price of the 210 strike here is $3.05. We are using the last traded price here. So if Microsoft moves by a dollar upwards, this option only moves 57 cents. So this means that this option moves to $3.62. Are you getting the hang on it? Want to do one more example? If you're enjoying this and you want to do one more example, do me a favor, click on like right now. So here we are now using a strike that is out of the money. So we are using a strike of 215. So that would be out of the money, and the delta is 0.27. So the current price of this option is $1.06. And so if the stock moves up by a dollar, this option only moves up by 27 cents. So even though the stock moves by a dollar, this only moves to $1.33. Did I do the math right? Okay, so first of all, let's talk about the things you need to know. Options that are in the money have a higher delta than options out of the money. So this means that in the money options behave more than a stock. Now, if you go back to our options chain here, you see that the delta for deep, deep, deep in the money options is 0.98. So this basically means that this option, if the stock goes up by a dollar, this option goes up by 98 cents. So the deeper in the money, the closer to one. But also, this is where you see the relationship here, right? Options that are ITM are more expensive, right? So this is where it's important that you see that there's a relationship between the delta and the price. The higher the delta, the higher the price, because the higher the delta, the more it is in the money. So typically, options at the money, which are right at where the strike price is, right at the level where the current price is, are usually around 0.5. So this is just as a rule of thumb. Now, you might also see this is where we just talked about call options. Now, put options have a negative delta, which is between minus 1 and 0. Because what does it mean? Well, the price of a put decreases if the option goes up. So this is why when we go over here, you see that the delta for put options is all negative. Now, put options that are in the money, this is where you see it right here, are usually closer to one, and options that are out of the money, they don't move a whole lot. So this is very important because some people just think, oh my gosh, I'm buying out of the money options because they are cheap. It is so much cheaper to pay $1.06 than $6.92. But as you can see, it's not really moving a whole lot. And the further out of the money you buy, see, if you want to buy a really, really cheap one of, let's say here, for only $31, then you see that the delta is only 10 cents. So it doesn't really move a whole lot. For every dollar that the stock moves, this option only moves 10 cents. Okay, what else you need to know? And I want to show you a really cool trick that you might not have known, because the delta is a rough estimate of the probability of the stock price closing above the strike. Did you know that? Now, if you have been trading options, you probably knew this. So here you see with a delta of 0.8, it means that there's an 80% probability right now that the stock will be above 205. There's a 27% probability that the stock will be above 215. So I think it's kind of cool as an option trader to know this. So the delta is giving you a rough approximation of how likely is it that the stock will be above or below the current strike price on expiration. Now, here is a tricky thing. The delta is not fixed. So the delta changes as the price changes. And here's why. Because right now, if, for example, Microsoft goes up to 215, the current strike price of 210 is deeper in the money, therefore the delta will be higher. Anyhow, so now you know what delta is, how it influences the option price, and you see that this is important when you are trading options. So Let me ask you, all of this that you have seen here, is this helpful at all? And would you like to see more videos like this? Because if you do and you enjoyed this video, click on like so that more people will see it. And if you want to see more videos like this, click on subscribe and hit the little bell, because this way you get notified whenever I release a new video. And also, if you think that this is cool stuff that you should share with your friends, feel free to share this video on Facebook, on Twitter, by email, right? Help spread the good word, and I will see you in the next video.